Hi all, myself Navid Ahmed. Today we are discussing about Kingdom Monera. General characters of Kingdom Monera. The bacteria are the sole member of Kingdom Monera. The Monerans are the most primitive microscopic unicellular prokaryotic organism. They are microscopic. They are very small. They cannot be seen by naked eyes. So we use microscope for observing Monerans. They are all unicellular. They have made up of only single cells. They are all prokaryotic organism. Here the genetic material does not have any nuclear membrane. So genetic material freely float in the cytoplasm. So they are prokaryotic organism. The bacteria occur almost everywhere. They are present in hot springs. They are present in salty areas. They are present in marshy areas. So they occur almost everywhere. The hundreds of bacteria present in a handful of soil. If you take a handful of soil, more than hundreds of bacteria are present in a handful of soil. They live in extreme habitats such as hot springs, deserts, snow, deep oceans, where only few life forms can survive. So they exhibit variety of the habitats. Many of them live in or on the organism as a parasite. These are the disease causing organism. They may be present inside or on the other organism and can act as an parasites. Next, based on their shapes, the bacteria are classified into four categories. They are Coccus, Bacillus, Vibrium, Spirillum. If you are observing the picture, the Coccus are spherical shaped. They are spherical in shape, but the bacilli are rod shaped. You are observe that in the second picture, they are rod shaped. But in the Vibrium, they are comma shaped. They are looking like a comma. These are the comma shaped. Spirillum are spiral shaped. Here after the shape, there are spiral shaped structures. So based on the shape, they are classified into four types. Next, the bacterial structure is very simple. They have complex in behavior. Compared to other organisms, the bacteria shows most extensive metabolic diversity. They show a most extensive metabolic diversity. Some bacteria are autotroph. They can prepare their own food from the inorganic substrates. By using sunlight, they can prepare their own food because they have chlorophyll pigment. That is, they may have photosynthetic pigments. They may be photosynthetic or autotrophic or chemosynthetic. They prepare their food by photosynthesis by using sunlight and chloroplast, as they are chemosynthetic also. So by oxidizing certain substance like nitrates and ammonia, they can prepare their food. So they are chemosynthetic also. The next, the vast majority of the bacteria are heterotrophs. They do not synthesize its own food, but depend on the other organism or on dead and decaying matter as for their food. Those organisms which feed on dead and decaying matter, they are called as saprophytes. Okay, so here observe the structure of bacteria. They have the genetic material in the nucleoid. The cytoplasm is present here. Cytoplasm, the nucleoid, the plasma membrane, the cell wall, and the spiles. Here the hair-like structures, there are spiles, and the ribosomes also present. Here they observe the flagellum, the locomotory organ, this flagellum. Next, classification of Kingdom Monera. The sole member of the kingdom are bacterians. So the Kingdom Monera are classified into Archaebacteria and Eubacteria. The Archaebacteria is further classified into halophiles, thermoacidophiles, and methanogens. And then Eubacteria is classified into autotrophs and heterotrophs. Autotroph means they prepare their own food. Heterotroph means they depend on other organism. In autotroph, they are further classified into photosynthetic autotrophs and chemosynthetic autotroph. Then heterotroph are further classified into parasitic and saprophytic. Here, so here, the details study about the Archaebacteria. Archaeon. What is Archaeon? Archaeon means primitive. So they are the primitive bacterians. Archaebacterians are the primitive bacterians. So Archaebacteria differ from other bacteria in having different cell wall structure. This feature is responsible for their survival in extreme harsh environmental conditions. So they have a different cell wall structure, so it is helpful in survival in a extreme harsh environmental condition. Based on their habitats, they are classified into three types. They are methanogens, halophiles, thermoacidophiles. Methanogens, these are the bacteria found in the gut of the several ruminant animals like cows and buffaloes. They are responsible for the production of biogas. So they are helpful in the production of biogas. They are present in the gut of the ruminant animal like cows and buffaloes. They are also present in marshy areas. So the name comes methanogens, means they help in the preparation of methane gas. Next one is halophiles. So it is halophiles. These are the anaerobic archaea bacteria which can live in an extreme salt condition. Halophiles mean the bacteria which live in extreme salty condition. Such bacteria are known as halophiles. Next one, thermoacidophiles. Thermo. So these are the also the anaerobic bacteria. So which can occur in a high sulfur springs, that is hot springs. They are present in a hot springs. Next, we move on to the eubacteria. Eu means true. These are the true bacteria. So they are characterized with the presence of rigid cell wall. If they are motile, they have a flagellum. There are two types: photosynthetic, the autotroph and heterotrophs. In that, the autotrophs are further classified into photosynthetic autotrophs and chemosynthetic autotrophs. Here, observe that photosynthetic autotrophs and chemosynthetic autotrophs. So here, first one is photosynthetic autotrophs. Example, cyanobacteria. They are also known as blue-green algae. They have chlorophyll similar to that of the green plant. The cyanobacteria are unicellular. They are having a single cell. They may be colonial or filamentous. They exhibit marine or terrestrial form. They are maybe terrestrial or marine. The colonies are generally surrounded by a gelatinous sheath. Their colonies generally surrounded by a gelatinous sheath. They differ from the. They often form blooms in a polluted water bodies. Some of these organisms can fix atmospheric nitrogen in a specialized cells. Is known as heterocyst. Example, Nostag and Anabina. What are heterocysts? The certain specialized cells are present in a photosynthetic autotroph, that is cyanobacterians. They have a specialized nitrogen fixing cells. They are known as heterocyst. The chemosynthetic autotrophic bacteria. These are the bacteria which oxidizes the various inorganic substances such as nitrates, nitrites and ammonia and use the released energy for the ATP production. So they play a great role in the recycling of the nutrient like nitrogen, phosphorus, iron and sulfur. The next one is heterotrophic bacteria. They are the most abundant in nature. The majority are important decomposers. They have very useful for human. They help in making curd from milk, in the production of antibiotics, fixing the nitrogen in leguminous roots, that is rhizobium. They fix the nitrogen in the leguminous roots. Some of them act as a pathogen that cause damage to humans, crops and animal pests. The cholera, typhoid, tetanus, citrus canker are well-known disease-causing bacteria. Next, we move on to the reproduction in bacteria. Bacteria reproduce mainly by fission. Sometimes during unfavorable condition, they produce spores. So bacteria reproduce by asexually by fission and spore formation. When the condition is favorable, it undergoes sexual reproduction. The sexual reproduction is by adopting a primitive type of DNA transfer from one bacteria to other bacteria. So it reproduces by asexually by fission and spore formation and sexually by transfer of genetic material from one bacterium to the another bacterium or other bacterium. So next, the mycoplasma. So this is one of the important topic in this chapter. The mycoplasma. These are the monerans which lack the cell wall. These are the smallest cell known and survive without oxygen. So they are anaerobic. Most of the mycoplasma is pathogenic in animals and plants. They may cause diseases in plants and animals. Example, pleuropneumonialic organism, PPLO. So which is the smallest cell known? The mycoplasma is the smallest cells. The smallest cell which can survive without oxygen. They lack cell wall. Thank you.